destined to rule, but pursued by shadows. A trusted friend, broken, but not defeated. A tyrant, wrapped in the darkness, ambitious and cruel. Three beacons lay cold on the corners of a kingdom. If their fires are lit, shadows will be pushed into the light. But if they stay dark, they will be a reminder of a future queen and her kingdom, forever ruled by the night. Finally, someone has come. My name is Franklin. This tower was my home, Iris's home, but was attacked by the king. He pursues Iris still, but she has escaped in the pages of a magical book. Find your way to the library in the town above. Save Iris. So much depends on you. The shipwreck was only the first step of your journey. Continue through the caverns and make your way to the town above. Your task will not be easy, but only when the beacon's light have removed the shadows will the town be saved. Quickly, continue making your way through the underground. Find us.
Thank you.
The creatures released have allowed access to the secret cavern. Behind its puzzle lie the steps into the kingdom where the beacons lay dark. You must be careful once leaving the safety of the underground. There are those that would see the beacon stay dark and a town trapped forever.
The same stranger that allowed Iris to escape has found a way out of the tower through the underground. Raven, you must keep them from reaching the girl. Guard the library.
Thank you. We'll be right back.
The doors of the library are now open. Iris waits for you inside. All will be made clear. Quickly, waste no time.
Thank you.
the children's wing. This hall held the laughter of children until the king attacked and the doors were locked. Find your way through its puzzles. See the world through the eyes of a child. Iris is close. Hurry. There isn't much time.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. same one that gave me my book. You helped me escape. I must ask for your help once again. You've lit the first beacon, but two remain. Find a way to light them so we can defeat the king and save the kingdom. We must succeed. I will join you soon.
Fires burn in the first beacon. Your failure does us both a great harm, Raven. Guard the last two beacons. Don't let anyone approach the violin door. Your shadows can be burned away. Do not forget this, and do not fail me again. Thank you.
Thank you.
hold me for the last time, Raven. Then slither into the darkness, or fly with your birds. I did not dispose of her family so that a stranger could restore that brat to the throne. Move aside, Raven. I will destroy that family once and for all.
Thank you. Thank you. You are a brave soul indeed, to be wandering on a night such as this. I will tell you more of the tale you've become a part of, if you can help me light my lantern and make my escape from this wretched place. And as light fills the lantern, darkness recedes. Poetic, don't you think? Enough of that. Take this key and find something that will release me from this dark forest. Help me, and I will tell you a tale. Yes, much better. You are a kind soul. Now for the show I promised you. Ah, yes. It appears the scene is incomplete. I'm afraid you will have to be a participant in this story. Oh, but you already are. Aren't you, my friend? Once upon a time, far across the sea, where the sun sets, there was a beautiful kingdom. In the center of the kingdom stood a glorious castle with three mighty beacons whose eternal flames reminded the people of the enduring power of imagination. Was an evil man, filled with bitterness and hatred. He rode the dark skies on wings of destruction, searching for a place to cast his blanket of shadows. When the evil man came to the kingdom, he was afraid of the creative minds of the people and vowed to destroy the land. He tore down the art, silenced the music, and blinded the citizens. The kingdom was cast into darkness, and the mighty beacons were extinguished. The evil man hunted the ruling family and silenced them all. Except for for one. But somewhere, even in the darkest night, a light always shines. You see, the youngest daughter of the ruling family escaped to a tall tower by the sea, where she was guarded and protected by a trusted friend. She painted her dreams full of characters and places and magical things. The evil king feared this girl above all else, and vowed to find and destroy her. Of the three beacons be lit and this young girl's destiny fulfilled? The answer lies with you, my friend. Succeed, and the rightful queen will be crowned and the shadows lifted. Fail, and we all are doomed to a dark and desolate future without hope or imagination. Good luck. Do what must be done.
evade me long enough to make sure the butler could take you away. He hid you well. Now he will spend an eternity broken in the tower you both called home. But here we stand.
Bow before the might of your king!
I'll never bow before a tyrant.
You foolish child. If you will not bow, then you will kneel. Behold, the might of the shadows.
And as shadows retreat from the beacon's light, a young girl becomes queen. Peace spreads over the people of the kingdom, and creativity flourishes once again. And here is where our story draws to a close. For with the wise rule of a young queen, and a people's belief in possibility and hope, a new day dawns for a land that was trapped in darkness for so long.